2 of the Fries.com Open in San Martin.
It's up at Coeur d'Alene, and everybody was looking to see if Tiger would improve after finishing 2-over-73 yesterday.
Tiger said his goal today was to shoot 64. Actually ended the day with a 3-under-par 68. He did make the cut, though, so he'll be playing on the weekend.
That's right. Action News reporter Mae Chow has been following the tournament. She's live now in San Martin.
Hi, Aaron and Dan. That's right, Tiger making the cut, but it took a while before he went to the green, a 2-hour fog delay. Things eventually cleared up at around 10. The sun came out and spectators enjoying what they came here to see, Tiger Woods in action, doing better. As you mentioned, he finished the day 3-under par and is now 1-under for the tournament. So overall, a huge improvement from yesterday. His fans, though, always by his side. They came out in droves today and were with him through every birdie and bogey. And I had a chance to ask Tiger what it was like to be back on the Central Coast, home to many of his faithful followers.
What's it like, following on his question, being back in the Central Coast? You have a lot of fans here.
Yeah, you know, I went to school not too far away from here and saw some of the team guys out here today. And so it's always nice to come back here. And, you know, to play in front of people that I know. And, you know, I saw a coach out here. So it's always good.
More than 10,000 people here today, and around 6,000 to 7,000 people at once following Tiger. They aligned the fairway and the green, and organizers say that number, 6,000 to 7,000, is a conservative estimate. So you can expect larger crowds tomorrow as Tiger is appearing. So obviously we know Tiger is the draw, but the food here also very popular. Golf is not my forte, but food is, and I can tell you that the food is very good here. The kitchen is headed up by Chef Luca Rotugliano, and he basically cooks up food for only members. So only members have a chance to taste his food, but spectators who come here this week, they have a chance to actually buy and eat some of the food that landed Chef Luca a spot on Food Network's Extreme Chef. So the lines, not as long as those for Tiger, but people still lining up to try his cheeseburgers and his sandwiches. And we got to go behind the scenes. You saw that video earlier in the kitchens that feed Tiger. So he actually cooks the meals for Tigers and the other players, members, and the more than 300 journalists from 90 different media outlets covering this tournament. So that's up from 100 journalists, so you can imagine how many mouths they have to feed. Again, expect a larger sea of Tiger, as you will, tomorrow. You have the food, you have the sunshine, you have Tiger. Daily attendance for the maximum daily attendance for Coeur d'Alene is 15,000 people. So this tournament this year, Dan, Aaron, on track to tripling.
There.
Yeah.
Well, and our resident foodie, we knew that you found the kitchen.
There you go. Luca Rotugliano, by the way, is at the Garlic Festival every year. He's on the cook-off stage there as well. So
didn't that food look good?
Yeah, he can cook, man. He knows his deal. So very good. Thanks, May. Appreciate
you,
it.
May.